Today I'm going to show you how you can schedule and email candidates from Excel. In some industries, there's a large turnover of staff and you're always forever interviewing. And the only industry I can think of off the top of my head is the construction industry. So for example, you have a position of a bricklayer here. And so in A1, I have bricklayer and then I have the date that the interview is set for. Our interview times, we have 6 spots in the morning and 6 spots in the afternoon. So now we have our list of candidates. These are names that I've generated from the random name generator. And so each of the candidates have indicated whether the morning's more suitable for them or the afternoon's more suitable for them. So what we're going to do is we're going to click the schedule button to run our schedule, and then we go back to our interview times and we have people slotted in for just about all of the times. I've put an extra space there because I'm sure in the list of people there's probably somebody that says, oh, I can't make it at 2 o'clock, and then you could possibly offer them either 4 o'clock or 11:30. So let's just go quickly through the code for this one. And so I call this set times, and I have my worksheets called candidates and I'm activating it. And so R equals 2 because I have heading rows, and do while candidates cells R1 does not equal blank, meaning that if there's no names there and you quit. Worksheet candidate cells R1 copy, so that is the names. Oops, let me get to the other sheet. So that R1 is the names. And if the worksheet candidate cells R3, and that is whether they've indicated morning or afternoon. So if it equals morning, then part of day is equals line 3 on the schedule, or else part day equals 7, which is line 7 for the afternoon. And so then we go worksheet interview times, activate, active cell range, cells part day, whether the afternoon or the morning, between 2 and 8, find the first blank cell, and then you're going to paste the names in the blank cell. And then we're going to go back to activate our candidates. We're going to add a row, and then we'll continue the loop. So this is fairly simple on how you can schedule the people in there. Okay, so then after that, what we're going to do is we're going to email each of these people. Since they've given us our email address, we're going to email them with their times. And so if I go to my schedule, I have Jasmine, and she's at 9 o'clock, and Harold's at 1:30. And so let's F8 through my code, and then let's see how both of them are given their time. And so I have send email address from Excel, and I have the normal setting everything up. Idate is interview date, itime is interview time, position is the name of the position they're applying for. Okay, so I'm going to select my candidate sheet again, and I'm once again going until I don't have anybody in there anymore. And then I'm defining my email address as the cells that are next to the name. Then we're going to select the worksheet candidates. And now what we're going to do is, so if they have indicated the morning, then what you're going to do is you're going to set the range to 3. That's where the morning names are. And they're going to find the name. And they're going to search the whole search order by column, search direction equals next, match case equals false, search format equals false, range select, active cell offset -1, 0. So what I want them to do is go above the name and find out what the value is of the time. So itime equals active cell value. And I will just comment this out. I was having trouble with my time, so I was giving the message box of itime on the 2 here. Okay, so then if it's not morning, then you're going to do the same thing, but you're going to go to the 7th row. and get the times from there. Okay, worksheet candidates activate. And so subject interview, the subject of the email is interview time. Idates is the one date that you have indicated in the top of the sheet in B2. The position is A1. And with Outlook email, you're going to say hello and invite you to your interview be held at our office. And this is the date and this is the time. Best regards, Barb. And then I have display here as opposed to send. And then I'm going to set iTime to zero so that nobody keeps getting 9 o'clock or whatever the last time. Then eaddress equals nothing. And x equals x plus one. And that will get us to the next row in the line. So let's just F8 through this and see what my email looks like. So I'm going from here. I'm quickly going through here. It's setting up the email. And now it's going to go to the candidates sheet. Now, the first one was obviously afternoon because we have jumped to the afternoon part. Okay, and then it's going to activate cell. And it's going to take the value. And now we're going to go back to the act and get the candidate sheet. And we're going to get the other information. We're going to get the interview time, idates, position, which is the name of the position that they're applying for. And then we're going to go through. And then we're saying, we'd like to invite you to the interview. This is the time and the date. And you can F8, and then we're going to display it. So here's my first interview. So I say, Harold, Harley Arnold, we'd like to interview you for Bricklayer to be held at our office on January 6, 2020 at 1:30 p.m. Best regards, Barb. Okay, so now I'm just going to close this because we don't really want to send it because I don't know if that person exists. And so now I'm going to go F8 through this again to see who the next person is. So the first person was in the afternoon. And let's go quickly through this and let's see what the second person is. I believe it's the morning. So that was quick. So there we have Jasmine is coming on the 6th for an interview at 9 o'clock in the morning. So that is how you schedule and email interview candidates from Excel. I'll include the code in my description of my video. Please subscribe.